One of the major challenges Uganda Cancer Institute faces today is irregular supply of medical services and sundries and the amount charged by national medical stores on supplying drugs is expensive than that sold on open market. The director of Uganda Cancer Institute, Dr. Jackson Orem, revealed to members of the Parliamentary Committee on Health who paid a courtesy call to the institute to familiarize themselves on the operations and services rendered at the institute. Dr. Riem told the visiting committee members that since National Medical Stores buys those drugs in bulk, they are expected to supply the drugs below the open market value. According to Riem, supplying these drugs at lower price would improve the availability of the drugs at the institute and reduce the stock out by 20%.
From the analysis, the institute loses about 2 billion shillings in overpricing from the national medical stores, and this is despite the fairly sizable budget that we do get, given. If that budget was managed effectively the way we thought it should be managed, I can say that we would be nearing 100%.
Other challenges the institute faces is understaffing, operational funds, and lack of chemotherapy protective gears for the staff, among others. The director was, however, disappointed with the members of the 9th Parliament for hijacking the Cancer Institute bill passed but has never been operationalized to date. Orem urged the new committee to investigate this issue.
And it's just a matter of us working with the Minister of Health, we can bring them out. And that is actually our role. And that is where there is a key demand that I'm going to press onto you. This delay, this what I would want to call hijack of the Uganda Cancer Institute bill should be investigated by you people, because these are the things that are delaying us from implementing things like this. Honestly, how could a bill that has been passed by Parliament be hijacked?
Uganda has high cancer morbidity, and according to the director of the institute, prostate cancer is the most common now in Uganda and has now taken over common cancers such as cervical, breast cancer, and Kaposi's sarcoma, which is associated with HIV. The good news is that the institute is in the forefront grappling with the disease, which is taking toll on the communities. Harris Thembo, WBS, Mulago Hospital.